Hey, hello, everybody, Eastern here, and today we are starting the long-awaited, by like 10 people, guide series to the Macrosis Ensemble Rework. This video will cover Rework Philip. Note that this is a review of modded content, so if you're looking for a guide on the original Ensemble Philip, I have provided a link in the description. There also is a link to the mod itself. Without further ado, let's get started. Reworked Philip has a lot more passive abilities than the original one. Spears 3 and Nova Fabric are retained, but besides them, Philip also has Crying Angel, Will of Wax, Erupting Nova and Candlelight, making the total amount of his base passive 6, leaving you with only 3 more passive slots. Now let's go through each passive and figure out the niche that Philip revolves around. Crying Angel is a passive that adds a new status element to the game, Burning Anguish. The status is given to Philip and one or two other allies each scene after Philip reaches Emotion level 1, and we'll dive deeper into its effect later. Crying Angel also gives Philip the ability to once per act revive an enemy upon killing them, and turn them into a Crying Child from the Crying Children exception. While it sounds like it only harms the player, the Crying Child only targets enemies, so it can be used as a tool to inflict tons of damage on other opponents through one-sided attacks. Philip's second passive is Will of Wax. This ability gives Philip a copy of Blazing Strike, a period exclusive to Philip variants, at the start of each act. It is important to note that the reworked Philip himself does not have access to Blazing Strike normally, and can only obtain it at the 10th space in his deck through this passive ability. The second part of Will of Wax activates as soon as Philip falls under 50% HP. It changes all damage resistances of Philip to Endured, while also making him weak against every type of stagger damage. While active, the passive also grants Philip full immunity to burn, more on its usefulness later. Next we have Erupting Nova. This passive is a combination of the three passives that define the unstable page of the Crying Children and later ensemble Philip as burn stackers. Those passives are Flaring Brand, Bloom Discussion, and Volatile Passion. Erupting Nova just takes all those abilities, powers up Flaring Brand so it buffs all dice instead of only buffing offensive dice, and puts them into one slot to save some space, which I can respect. Also, it does not stack with any of the aforementioned passives, so no, you cannot get a +2 to offensive dice against a target with burn. The last new passive of Reward Philip is Candlelight. This passive inflicts 2 burn to Philip each scene and gives him buffs for every 4 burn he has, up to 3 stacks. The buffs are +1 max value to all dice, 1 or 2 damage from hits, inflicting 1 additional burn on hit, and most importantly, reducing the cost of random burlinated page in hand by 1 for the scene. This is the part where I want to tell you about my unnecessary opinion on the fact that I adore the fact that Macrosis didn't go with an obvious simple buff like +1 power for every 4 burn, but instead made Candlelight with it. That makes Philip much more fun to play. Okay, now that you're familiar with the passives, time to roughly figure out when and where to use reworked Philip. Being a variant of Philip, this key page is obviously burn focused. With 3 copies of Clone in your deck, you can do what every other Philip does. Copy and spam Blazing Strike with Happy Memories, but more efficiently as you now have one more page to support. Speaking of efficient Blazing Strike spam, did you know that Ensemble Rework also changes the properties of certain pages? One of such pages is Rekindled Strike. Its dice rolls are unchanged, but now on use inflicts 3 burn to the user, reduces the cost of a copy of Blazing Strike by 1, and deletes Blazing Strike's emotion level restriction, and instead gives the page the ability to draw 2 pages and inflict 5 burn to the user on use. This page durability almost ensures the usage of at least 1 copy of Blazing Strike every scene, but the burn self-infliction acts as a built-in counter to the abuse of the strategy that will drop you to the activation threshold of Will of Wax, making you feel vulnerable to stagger damage. Still, even with such a limit in place, it's not that big of a deal, as you can still have half of your HP, and by building a team with multiple strong and fast clashes like Tanya, or mass stack spammers like Xiao or Ominous Power Yan, you can redirect and delete clashes coming at Philip, and in Xiao's case specifically, even help him with burn infliction. But what about the other uses for Philip? Well, this is where Burning Anguish comes in. The status gives Philip the ability to stack negative emotion coins upon winning clashes and killing enemies. You can get Burning Anguish by activating Crying Angel, and by using Flames of Despair or Inconsolable Grief. This gives Philip the role of an emotion support. To utilize this, however, you will have to put him on the floor with strong breakdown under melody pages, so Melkis will no longer be Philip's preferred floor in this scenario. This type of support performs fantastically on Tifras, with a dual Exodia setup. By giving himself and the Exodia Librarian's text of Burning Anguish, Philip can drastically speed up the process of getting all the necessary pages for the activation of Nyx. While this doesn't exactly involve burn, I would still highly advise using a burn focus deck on Philip, as it will give him a way to buff his dice and inflict more damage on the opponents that can deal with the Exodia setup early. Here is a random singleton burn deck I built on him, if you're too lazy to make one yourself. It doesn't perform perfectly, and I highly advise you to modify the deck to your own preference. It consists of 1 copy of Graze the Grass, 1 copy of Forward March, 1 copy of All Out War, 1 copy of Molten Slash, 1 copy of Fiery Dragon Slash, 1 copy of Flames of Despair, 1 copy of Will of the Prescript, 1 copy of Xi Wen, and 1 copy of Rekindle Strike. If you want, you can charge All Out War for Will of the City for better deck sustainability. And that's all I have to say about the reworked page of Philip from the Macrosis Ensemble Rework mod. I would recommend to check it out if you've beaten the game and want to beat other modded deceptions, but I'd say the characters are way too overpowered for the base game, so using them would kill the fun of overcoming a difficult boss. If you want more videos like this, consider giving this one a like and subscribing to the channel. It helps me out a lot, as seeing that number go up makes me just a little bit more motivated to make the next video sooner. On the topic of making videos quickly, my video making pace is about to drop drastically due to the end of summer break, so I hope you can understand the lack of frequent uploads. I'll try my best to keep it at least at 2 per week, maybe 3 per week, if I can. So yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you around. Goodbye!